Hello everyone! Again, you can watch me experiment with dripping different colorants like mica pigments, alcohol ink and pigment paste on top of a clear layer of resin. And I'm going to do this on three layers to create some nice depth. And I'm using an artboard of 30 centimeters, so not that large. And I taped the sides so that the resin will stay on top of my MDF artboard. And I'm starting with the first layer. The first color is an alcohol ink from Tim Holtz. It's from Ranger and it's the color Indigo. And this is a pigment paste from Color Obsession, the Bonaire Blue. And on top, some resin with one drop of Indigo mixed in it. And I'm dripping those colors on top of each other to see what kind of effects I can create. It's all about experimenting for me. And yeah, I don't know how to call this technique, so I'm calling it the dripping technique. If someone has a better name, then please place it in the comments below this video. The white is the Casting Craft white. And all the inks that I'm using are from Tim Holtz Ranger. And you can also find all the supplies I've used in this video at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video, with the links to the website, as I always do. Because I used a lot of different pigments. Also some clear in the middle. And the resin I'm using is from the Resin Pro company. It's the Art Pro resin. So it has a medium viscosity resin. Medium viscosity, and the link to their website is in the description box. Also the promo code to their website, my promo code is Petra. If you use it, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. So the violet color is also from Ranger. It's the Twilight Purple. Tilting it a little bit to the center again. And I don't have a plan in my head. I only have a plan for the colors, but not the order of which I put the colors on top of each other. This is one of my newer mica pigments. It's the Gilded Rose. Very nice rose gold color. And on top some white. The Twilight Purple. And then some clear. And so you can see, it. If you pour it on top of each other, or drip it on top of each other, it will spread to the sides. Again, the Gilded Rose. Some clear to push the color to the outside. There you can see it. Some white again. And this is the Honeycomb. It's also an alcohol ink. Very nice color. And as I'm doing this, I'm watching what kind of effects I'm getting. So if the end result is not that nice, it doesn't matter, because I want to test all those colors on top of each other. And then maybe in the next piece recreate it, the effect that I got. This is the citrus, very nice color. I'm also using some clear alcohol. There you can see it. Yeah, I'm using those mica pigments and pigment paste to see how it reacts to the alcohol ink if you drip it on top of each other. Yeah, I'm also using my airbrush to see what kind of effects I can create with that. And it's cool air, because if I use hot air from a heat gun, then the alcohol ink will dry too fast. So that's not what I want. That's why I'm using my airbrush, yeah, to push those colors to the outside. I love those rings, they are very nice. Again, I'm using the airbrush. Making some lines, there you can see it. I hope you all saw my short videos of my friend's build-up, so now you know who's making those background noises, because he can snore very loud. And what I also want to mention, that at the moment in my Etsy shop, but also the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer, we have a Labor Day sale, and it runs for a week from August 30th until September 7th, and it's shop-wide, so on all our items in our shop we have a discount of 20%. So yeah, for the people that like my mica pigments and all the other supplies I have in my shop, and also in a USA Canada shop, go take a look at our Etsy Labor Day sale of 20% discount. So the link to our Etsy shop is in the description box below this video. Also the Etsy shop of Evelyn Schaefer in the USA. And yeah, a very interesting discount. And what I need to mention is that you get the discount in the USA Canada store if you order above $50. And in my shop for the rest of the world, if you order above 30 euro, then you get that discount of 20%. Yeah, I'm liking the effect of the lines I made in the blue. but also the nice rings of the warm yellow, that's the honeycomb, with the mica pigments. Now you can't see the colors that well, but at the end of this video I'm showing you a close-up and then you can see it much better. But it are some very nice bright colors. I love to work with bright colors. So I'm almost done with the first layer, and then I'm going to show you how it looks after 1 hour of drying. So yeah, 1 hour later, and now it looks this way, and I'm already liking those lines, the nice effects. Now you can see it, also the lines in the blue. So I will let this dry and then I will start on the second layer. And also dripping those colors on top of each other using different colorants. But this needs to dry for 24 hours. So we are 24 hours later. I'm starting with white on the edge. It's the casting cloth white with a thin line. I still have the tape around my artboard of 30 centimeters, and the rest will be clear resin. Again, I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro resin. But it dried very well. Some nice effects. So on the second layer I'm going to again experiment with dripping different colors on top of each other, using the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. I think you can hear my French bulldog now, he's making a lot of noise. But yeah, you know how he looks now if you watch my short video. And he always makes a lot of noise. I can't tell him to not make that noise. So I already am further in the process. I'm going to show you how I make these puddles. I'm using the indigo, the turquoise, and some caustic cloth white, and of course some clear, there you can see it. Drip those colors on top of each other. There again the white, the turquoise, and then watch what kind of effects I can create. Again a little bit further in the process. Also using clear alcohol, there you can see it. Some white in the middle. Again the turquoise. Some clear alcohol. There you can see the indigo, the turquoise, and some clear. Then white, turquoise, and some clear. And then wait what effects I get. But I think it looks nice. Also on top of the white paste, I'm using a drop of alcohol to see what it does, how it reacts to each other. Yeah, I keep letting the camera rolling so you can see also what effects I create and what the order is of adding those different colorants on top of each other. So a little bit of clear in the middle. And then some white, and then I'm using the honeycomb to create some contrast in these puddles. Yeah, I can see it, one drop, two. Drop of clear alcohol. And I'm using the 99% alcohol. You can also use 95 or 70. And the blue and the yellow create a nice green shade. And so you can see, you can still see the first layer through the second layer, so that's nice. So in this layer I'm only using alcohol ink and a white paste. In my first layer I also used mica pigments to see if that works or not. But the white is the paste and the rest are all alcohol ink. And I'm also using clear alcohol. There you can see it. So this is after 1 hour of drying. I wanted to show you a close-up so you can see the effects a little bit better. Very nice. Well, I hope it stays this way. But yeah, you never know, during drying it could change a lot. But I will let this dry for 24 hours and then I will start on the next step. Yeah, here I'm showing you a part of how I add the acrylic lines. I'm using a very thin white marker, it's from Posca, and I'm also going to use the FIFA Decor glitter pens in the colors green, dark green, emerald and light blue, and I'm also using some gold glitter lines. But I'm only going to show you a part of this. I already did the rest, so you can see. Yeah, and I like to work with these Posca markers. They work very well on top of resin. And here you can see me use the Viva de Gar glitter pen. I also attached a thinner tip. You can buy all kinds of tips for these glitter pens. And if you like thin glitter lines, then these pens are amazing. I use these pens a lot also on my larger resin art pieces, but also in coaster molds or tray molds, whatever silicon molds you have. They work very well. So the lines are dry, now I'm going to add a third layer, and again I'm going to add different colors on top of this clear layer of resin. A little bit more. Still have the tape around my artboard. Spreading it with my stirring stick. And I'm already further in the process. This is one of my mica pigments, the Gilded Rose. The red is the nice sassy red from Lares. It's a paste, and white is also a paste. And on top of the white, I'm using my Sparkle White mica pigment in some clear. Then the Gilded Rose again, the sassy red, some white, and a drop of Honeycomb alcohol ink, and then the Sparkle White again. So I'm dripping those colors on top of each other. This time I'm using mica pigments, pigment pastes, and also alcohol ink. And I'm using my how do you call this? It's not a large heat gun, but to push those colors to the center. Oh, embossing tool. That's the word for the smaller heat gun I use. And the Sparkle White is an amazing pigment. You can use it as is in resin, but also you can add it to another color, a mica pigment or an ink, and then it gets a really beautiful sparkle. There you can see it again, the sassy red, some white, a drop of honeycomb, again some white, and then I'm using my embossing tool to push the color to the center and then see what effect I can create, because the embossing tool, the heat from it is not cool. So it's warm, and then, yeah, I wanted to test it. And the Gilded Rose is just an amazing mica pigment. It's a very nice color. But I'm getting some nice effects. I can imagine that some people don't like all these bright colors. But it's an experiment. If it doesn't look nice, then it's no problem. But my goal is to learn something from this. And it already has some great depth because you can still see the first layer. You can see the blue second layer and now the third layer. So in the middle again some clear with sparkle white. On top a drop of honeycomb, the alcohol ink. You can already see it sparkle. Very nice. A little bit of clear again. Making some lines to the center. So now I've used mica pigments, alcohol ink and pigment paste to see how they react to each other, but also some clear alcohol. And I think I created some nice effects, hopefully they will stay. So this is the end result. I have it outside in the daylight. I've added a clear layer of resin and I think I have some amazing effects. There you can see it. There you can see the glitter lines and also the depth is amazing. And for sure I will experiment with this dripping technique a little bit more. To see if I can create other effects or recreate some effects that I have now. But I think it looks very nice, the effects. And some nice bright colors. So if you like what I'm doing and you haven't subscribed, consider to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video. The information to our Labor Day sale is in the description box below this video for the 20% discount. All the links to the supplies I've used you can find there. I want to thank you all for watching again and I will see you in the next video. Bye!